Hi, my name is Julia, and I'm here with Carolyn in Georgia to present our lab's work on re-envisioning drip irrigation systems for Sub-Saharan Africa. By 2050, the growing world population will require a 50% increase in food production above 2010 levels. This need will be felt especially strongly in Sub-Saharan Africa, where the population will more than double. In order to sustainably intensify food production in this region while protecting its water resources, farmers need a water-efficient, low-cost way to irrigate their fields. Drip irrigation, which distributes water through a pipe network directly to the roots of each crop, can reduce water use by 20 to 60% over traditional irrigation methods. Therefore, we are designing a new generation of low-cost, user-friendly, solar-powered drip systems for Sub-Saharan Africa.
Every new technology has to work for end users in order to be successful. By interviewing farmers, learning from market stakeholders, and interfacing with our research team, we're generating knowledge about how we should design irrigation systems that have high likelihoods of adoption. We have developed four personas of farmers in Sub-Saharan Africa: the traditional smallholder, the semi-commercial smallholder, the remote farmer, and the medium-scale contract farmer. We've discovered their corresponding irrigation needs, and we're developing system architectures that meet these needs.
Then the needs are used to design a system. A solar-powered drip irrigation system is made up of interdependent components, namely a pump, a hydraulic network, emitters, and solar panels that power the pump. We found that existing software modeled subsystems independently and doesn't allow for holistic optimization, which can lead to improper system design. So we created a custom system-level model and design tool that allows us to simulate the system operation and optimize the system design holistically.
Finally, to get the lowest cost and most efficient system possible, we redesigned drip emitters to operate at low water pressures. This reduces the pumping power, leading to smaller and lower cost pumps and solar arrays. We've prototyped emitters that operate at lower pressure than comparable commercial products and have conducted field trials which showed pumping energy savings of 40 to 70% on 9 different farms.
Our team approaches water and food security in Sub-Saharan Africa by redesigning drip systems at 3 different scales: the emitters, the systems, and their ability to satisfy user needs. Over the next year, learnings from these different perspectives will all come together into field pilots that we will test in Kenya. After that, we will use our findings to repeat the design process for other global markets. Thank you to the rest of the Gear Lab team and to our partners who are helping us bring water-efficient irrigation technologies into the hands of millions of farmers.